Hey, welcome to Luxury in Moderation, where we appreciate the finer things in life without going overboard. If you're new here, my name's Joanne, and every week I upload videos about luxury handbags and other luxury lifestyle products to hopefully give you some really good advice, or if you're just curious about these topics. So if you like what you hear, please consider subscribing. And if you're a returning subscriber, thank you so much for being on this luxury journey with me already. So in today's video, we have a little bit of a different background and a little bit more casual. So that's because today I'm supposed to fly to Hawaii and hopefully everything goes off without a hitch. I'm still a little bit nervous because there are some safety considerations to think about, but I thought I would bring you along with me. This will be my first attempt at a vlog, so I hope the editing turns out all right. So I first wanted to start off with some travel tips and also show you what I'm packing in my suitcase and carry-on. And basically, I did already fly since everything shut down last year. For Thanksgiving, I was on a short flight. And I learned a couple things from that trip that I want to share with you guys. And of course, the thing I want to focus on is safety. So I was actually very, very nervous to be on a flight for the first time with the pandemic still going on. So I ordered some very good N95 masks, which I'll link down below. And then in addition to having masks, I also thought of putting on a face shield. I got it at CVS and it kind of like went around my forehead here. There was an elastic, so it stayed on pretty well, actually better than I thought it would. I thought it would keep on like popping off or something, but it didn't. So I had that on the 2-hour flight and it was very, very uncomfortable. Basically because you're still like, your hot breath is like all caught up in the mask, and then that steams up the face shield, and I couldn't see very well, and my face was just hot, but I couldn't wipe anything away, obviously. So I don't want to do that this time. And basically, one of the things I had a question about with all of these security measures and going through airport security is that they do still ask you to take off your mask when they are checking your ID before you get through security. So, you know, if you have all this protection on going into the airport, trying not to touch anything, you stand in line, you show your passport, you give them your ID, and then they do ask you to take off your mask so they can see your full face. So then I was kind of like, you know, everything was on so tight. I like pulled it down for a split second and then I tried to put it back up, but then it like everything shifted and I felt like nothing was right and it was uncomfortable. So that's just one thing to keep in mind. If you are going to be traveling soon, they do ask you to take your mask off at that moment. Okay, so now let's get down to some of the things that I packed. This is my first time going to Hawaii. It was supposed to be my honeymoon trip in 2020. Obviously, that did not happen, but we thought, let's just try to go to Hawaii anyways. So I have definitely a lot of sunblock. So this one is like for your face, and then this one is a little bit water resistant. We're hoping to do a little bit snorkeling, so wanted to get a lot of that done. And then of course, sanitization wipes. I have 2 packs of these. Basically, I try to wipe down everything that I can, all the airport seats, trays, you know, things in hotels. So I definitely think I'll be going through these. And also just once in a while, wiping your hands if you don't have access to, you know, a bathroom to wash your hands. And then I do have a rash guard. So again, just some sun protection while we are snorkeling or, you know, being in the water. I did bring 3 pairs of swimsuits because I have a thing for like bikinis and swimming and like that lifestyle, but obviously I did not get to use any of that in 2020, so I wanted the opportunity to wear more swimsuits. And then I'm not gonna show a lot of the clothes that I have. I didn't bring a lot of nice clothes, mostly workout clothes, because I feel like it's gonna be sweaty and hot anyways. So then let's get into the carry-on bag that I will be using and how I will be packing that. So this is the bag that I decided to bring as my carry-on and also my day bag in Hawaii.
and it's my Kate Spade nylon striped tote bag. So I think basically it's light and it's easy to clean. So, and I also don't use it very much, so I thought I should use it on this trip. So the very first thing that I'm gonna do is transfer my, you know, cards and things that I need into my Kate Spade wallet. Just because it's lighter, I don't need everything that I need in my regular life, so that'll be just a good paring down. And then, of course, I have my Audrey Hepburn everything mom bag. Basically, there's, you know, Advil in here, Band-Aids, everything of that sort. And then I always like having a pack of tissues with me, so that's coming with me. And then I have a pair of sunglasses because, of course, we need sunglasses in Hawaii. We have hand sanitizer. So I just went to grab this one at Target yesterday. Basically, I just wanted to get something that could hook onto the outside of my bag so I didn't have to like dig for it and basically contaminate the rest of my purse. So that one's going to hang on the outside. I am also going to bring a hat, because, you know, again, more sun protection. So there's my Lulu hat. And then I have some backup hand sanitizer in case I run out. That's like the number one thing that I'm concerned about. And then finally, I am going to bring a good book on the plane. So this is the one that I'm working on now. I'm very, very excited about it. I also have downloaded episodes of Gossip Girl on my iPad, so I'll probably watch some of that because it's a very long flight there and back. But these are the essentials, and I can't wait to share the rest of my trip with you guys.
Thank you.
Aloha, everyone. So as you can see, I'm back home and I am wearing a couple of souvenirs that I got. And we will be unboxing a few more things that I purchased while I was there. But before we get into that, I wanted to mention some things that I forgot to talk about during the first part of this video. So for people in the United States traveling to Hawaii, they are allowing people to get tested before getting on the island. So you don't have to do either like a 14 or a 10-day quarantine now. So I did have to go through that process. I looked for a testing center near me, which was a Walgreens center, and I got the rapid test so that I could get the test results within the flying time. And then I was able to go through the Hawaii travel site to get my quarantine waived. So if you have any questions regarding traveling to Hawaii and the restrictions, let me know below. I know I was very worried about it when, you know, going through the process, but now that I'm on the other side, I feel pretty confident, and you know, as long as you follow the steps that they ask for, you won't be required to quarantine once you get there. And then in terms of packing, I did forget to mention that I was bringing my Coach wristlet. So this I was able to fit in my smaller wallet, and also a folded up copy of my negative test results. So, you know, in case anywhere that I went, they wanted to check and ask for this, then I would have that handy. And this came in really, really handy when, you know, I needed to just run out and pick up some things or go somewhere really fast and not have to bring my whole Kate Spade purse. I could just grab the wristlet. So it's still being really well used after having it for so many years. And now let's get into the first part of my Hawaii haul. So in this video, I'm going to talk about two things that I bought in Hawaii, but stay tuned for a Hawaii haul part two because there is something bigger that I will show in a separate video. So the very first thing that I bought in Hawaii was a new pair of Havanas. So these are really great flip-flops. I already have a pair and they're getting quite old, so I thought now would be the perfect time to replace them. You know, there's lots of flip-flop shops all over Hawaii, and of course we can get Havaianas now. I don't know if I'm pronouncing that correctly, sorry. But I chose this pair specifically because it was an exclusive design to all the Hawaii islands. So basically you can't purchase this design anywhere else. So it's basically like a pink base and then kind of like a rose gold strap part. But then what I thought was super special was they have a little sea turtles on top as a little decoration. And basically I had a really close encounter with a sea turtle when we were out snorkeling, so it was very fun to be so near wildlife, and they are so beautiful and cute. And then I also walked past a sign that described what the different tattoos mean for people on island, and they said that the sea turtles actually represents long life, fertility, and peace. So I thought that was really special. I thought this pair was really special just because you could only get it on the islands. So it was like a really nice piece to remember this trip by. And you know, I also love the color. So now let's get into this orange box here. And basically I wanted to go to the Hermes in Hawaii because a lot of people here on YouTube mentioned how the Waikiki store was a really great place for them to shop. Hawaii is just a good tourist center anyways, so they have a lot of stock, and a lot of people have said that they have gotten offered a Birkin there, and that is just really special. So for me, I'm not ready to, you know, purchase a Birkin yet, but I thought it would be just a nice experience to go to the store, maybe even purchase some smaller item there to remember my trip by. So I was looking on the Hermes website even before I got on island, and I was looking at a pair of their Aloha shoes. So their Aloha shoes are like a rubber slipper. And I thought that would be kind of like a nice smaller item to purchase. So as soon as I got to the store, that's what I asked to see. And I tried it on, and unfortunately, they only had two colors. I think during this season or during this time, even on the Hermes website, it's only the black color and the red color. And I was hoping that I would love the red color more, but once I put it on, it really didn't wow me. Even though the slippers were very comfortable, the silicone or rubber or whatever they're made out of, it was very smooth. I really enjoyed feeling them on my feet. And I thought, you know, they're called the Aloha sandals. What better way to remember Hawaii by? But I guess even for their lower price point of $300, I didn't know if I loved them enough to spend that much money. So I started trying on some of their other slippers, and I did come across this pair. So let's open this up so you can see which pair I actually got. And this is a true unboxing. I haven't opened the box since I came home from the store. So really excited to finally see these shoes again. And let me know if you think you know which pair I got. Basically, again, wonderful packaging. These are the Oran sandals, very soft tissue paper. But I did get a pair of their orange Oran sandals, a very bright orange. So I did get this in my true size, which is a size 37. I had tried on the size 36.5, but they were just a touch small. And then in the Aloha sandals, they didn't come in a half sizing. So I had tried on like a 36 and that fit well. So I think the Hermes sizing for shoes varies according to style. So it's really important for you to really go in and try to see which size will fit. I've heard that these Oran sandals are very comfortable. I am not sure I've experienced that yet, just because I don't know if these are new and they're a little bit harder, but that they, if they will mold to my feet a little bit more over time. But I also know that a lot of people have them, a lot of people rave about them. So I'm very, very excited to start wearing these once it gets a little bit warmer where I am. So I'll just put this here for now as I give you some more details. As you can see, they also provided a large postcard as part of the packaging. So that was very nice. And it's just a cute design of a depiction of their Waikiki store. So that's really cute. And then here is more information on the pricing. So it was $630, so same as on the website, same as if you bought them anywhere. But then what really shocked me was that their tax rate is 4.7%, which only added another $29. So basically, after I, you know, asked for the price of these including tax, and I realized that the tax wasn't that much in Hawaii, I was like, oh my gosh, now I understand why people buy things in Hawaii. And that really got me excited and made me want to go shop some more to see if I could, you know, get some nice items without the higher tax prices here in my home state. So I was really pleasantly surprised about that. Originally, I hadn't wanted to spend that much at Hermes because, as I mentioned, I was only looking at the Aloha sandals, which is half of the price of the Oran sandals, but I'm really glad that at least the sales tax didn't add too much more to the price. And that led me to basically do more shopping and find another piece that I have been thinking about for a while. So stay tuned for that video. I am so grateful to have been able to go to Hawaii and traveled a little bit in this stressful time and gotten to experience my first time there, it was different with everyone wearing masks and everyone being especially cautious, but I still really enjoyed my time, and thank you guys so much for watching. If you have any questions or comments about my trip, feel free to leave them below, and remember to subscribe if you haven't already. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!